no. Oh, no. Hurry. Hurry, wake up. Those terrible men. They've taken our things. Hurry. 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 Oh. Oh. Hurry.
Pay attention, all of you. This is Dr. Peta Clements. He's a psychologist. He'll be working here for a while.
Why aren't you at university, Travers?
Because my tutor's standing right next to you, Miss Bennett.
Don't be smart.
You are.
Ladies, I hope I can rely on you to help me as much as you can. I'm sure we're going to get along together very well.
Gonna do a bit of work on the couch, are we, Doc?
Unfortunately not. Well, I hope I see you all later.
Oh, you little beauty.
Hey! Where are you? Get out of this park! I'm gonna read your face!
You bastard, Fred. You rotten little bastard. I only did it for you.
Going.
Will you relax? She's not going to come looking for me on the streets. Oh, come on, Freddy. Now, where's the dough? Oh, Fred.
Poor old Monty.
If you're going to feel sorry for her, I'm going to think you don't love me.
Well, she just got out the nick, see?
She's got no cause for complaint then, is she?
Nah. Let's shoot out the Tullamarine and disappear, eh?
No hurry. Never been rich in Melbourne before. You?
No.
Well, then why don't we just stick around and have some fun? Oh, come on, Fred. Anyone could be rich in Acapulco or that, but in your own hometown, doesn't that turn you on?
Well, yeah, I suppose so, but...
It turns me on, Freddy.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah. Get ourselves a nice quiet room somewhere, sort of catch our breath and make plans.
I don't know. How about surfers? We could be there in a few hours.
Surfers? Oh, I'm going to play havoc with my skin.
Oh. Well, how about...
I've got real delicate skin, Freddy. Here. Have a feel.
Oh, yeah. Real delicate.
It's like that all over, Fred.
Oh. Well, maybe a couple of days in a nice, quiet motel. I'd be all right, I suppose. And then it's off into the wild blue yonder.
You said it. Of course, we're going to need a few things if we're going away.
Oh, anything you like, Blossom.
Yeah, I'm so excited.
Hello? Oh, Monica Ferguson. Here's Fred there. Oh, hasn't been in at all. Oh, look, it's none of your business. No, I am not looking to thump him. Okay, none taken. Look, if you do see him, will you give me a ring? Thanks, all. Yeah, right, bye.
You've got the nerve to come in here.
Oh, don't look at me like that, Sol. What are you? 40, 45?
50.
Okay, everything's all right.
I'm a man of my word, Sol. What'll you have, darling?
Oh, Brandy Alexander.
I'll have a double Chivas Regal, Sol. Have one yourself, or plant a tree in Israel, whichever you like.
Some relative died?
No, me ship came in. Don't suppose you know Miss Blossom Crabtree, do you, Sol?
Well, not personally. Last time I saw Miss Crabtree perform, she called herself Princess Fatima. Very artistic act, with snakes.
That was years ago. Things you have to do to make ends meet.
Oh, I understand, love.
Here you go. Oh, cheers. Far be it from me to spoil the festive spirit, Fred, but your wife called a few minutes ago.
Yeah?
Not a very happy woman, Fred.
No. Well, of course, you haven't seen me, have you?
Your business is your business.
Okay, Blossom, come on, drink up.
I like it here.
Look, there's a real classy motel just over the road. We can get a bit of quiet there, and you can try on your new stuff.
Sure.
Oh, would you look at that?
I'm looking.
In my opinion, the man's come at a most unfortunate time.
I do wish you would sit down, Mr. Fletcher.
Thank you, ma'am.
Why do you say that?
Well, during the settling in period. Before we've had time to take up all the slack.
But then you and I may not be quite clear on what exactly is slack.
Yes, well, of course, policy is your province, Mrs. Davidson. But still, the uniformed staff carry the can from day to day.
My policy is to be flexible. I try to allow whatever freedom is possible.
Yes, but the women end up with too much time on their hands. Now, I've seen exactly the same thing in the army. You give the blokes an option and they sit on their tails every time. If you give people too much time to sit and look at their navels, they fall apart at the seams. I know, I've seen it.
Hence your exercise program.
Well, exactly. I mean, that's a case in point. Now, the women are overweight, dopey, and a lot of energy is being spent in the, in the wrong areas.
Such as?
Well, unnatural areas. Well, I know that the women have been deprived of the outlet that nature intended, but still, that's no excuse for the sort of behaviour that I've witnessed personally. I mean, that business with Anderson and Warner in bed together, for example.
Yes, go on.
Well, the officer that I was with was inclined to turn a blind eye to it. Now, where are we? I mean, is that behaviour on or not?
Well, there's not very much we can do about it. Unless, of course, we lock them in separate cells. And I think you'll agree that is neither humane nor practical.
No, well, I'm afraid I can't be that complacent, Mrs. Davidson. Now, with your permission, the exercise program will continue. And we'll just see what happens.
Oh, excuse me, I just wanted to return these.
Very well, Mr. Fletcher. We'll see how it goes.
Thank you, ma'am.
Carry on, Dr. Clements.
Are you sure that I'm not,
Quite sure.
Smoker. Might as well. Day's nearly over anyway. And here comes our little ray of sunshine.
Money must have got your loot in a safe place by now, eh?
Yeah, unless you've done a bunk with it.
Well, you two shut up. God knows who's listening.
Afternoon, ladies.
See what I mean? Oh, don't worry about the doc. He won't go lagging on us, will you, Doc?
Certainly not.
See? He's doing scientific research.
That's what I told them. Cigarette anyone?
Oh, damn. Gee whiz. Not in my brand. Spun him a bit of a line, did you, Doc?
Had to. You know what they're like down there.
Fair idea going by this place.
Right. This place is like the inside of their quaint 19th century minds. Well, I could hardly tell them their lovely prisons are a complete waste of time, could I?
Oh, so that's what your book's going to be about?
Shh. Don't you go lagging on me either.
Cigarette, Doreen?
Getting through your smokes there, Doc.
Ah, plenty more where they came from. Here, have the package.
Oh, Tad.
See, the truth is, you ladies have got them licked. They spend all this money. They put nice bars on all the windows. They hire friendly screws to look after you day and night. And what happens?
We keep them on the hop.
Right. You won't behave yourself. Funny thing, that, isn't it?
Sounds like you're on our side.
What's going on here?
Our smoke goes over, girls.
Have permission to be in here?
No. Does it matter?
Well, visitors are restricted to certain areas.
Oh, I see. Very well. See you anon, ladies.
Yeah, drop in any time.
Joyce, you have a visitor. Oh, Monica Ferguson.
Nice of you to come out, Moni.
It's okay. Got a message for you. How you doing?
Oh, you know, nothing changes in here.
No. Things change outside, but...
Yeah?
You can bank on it.
So you saw me Auntie Madge, then?
Yes, sends her love. Sure took a load off her mind seeing me. Got a match?
Oh, yeah. Did you try that little shop I told you about?
Yeah. Very cooperative. Mention your name and, all doors open. Got a whole bunch of goodies for the old girl.
Oh, glad to hear it. How's Fred?
Oh, yeah. All right.
You be going away on a holiday, you know, when your money comes through from your shop?
Pretty soon.
Well, good luck to you and thanks for seeing me, Auntie.
It's okay. Give me love to be, you know.
Yeah, I'll do that.
Hello, Bruce? Blossom. No, listen. I'm at the Bonanza Motel with this guy. And he's got a roll of nugs that are choke horse. I think 6-7 grand. Yeah, well, that's what I thought. The old routine, eh? All right, then, look, I'll keep him occupied till you get here. Shouldn't be any problem. Yeah, what? The Bonanza Motel, room 403. Right. Okay, Mum, now, you look after yourself and do exactly what the doctor says, right? Okay, bye. Mum's not well.
Oh, dear.
I'm afraid. You give me goosebumps all over. Come to Mama.
Oh, Blossom.
Got a load on them.
Too right. I said to my Bronwyn, you come down and help me. But would she?
What do you expect? Nobody cares for anybody.
Fancy saying charity begins at home.
Don't talk to me about charity. A friend of mine, the only friend I had, was killed by a charity last night.
You don't say.
Good as. They wanted to split us up. Horry wasn't having any. Let them keep their charity, he said.
Oh, gentleman friend.
I don't know what they thought we'd get up to.
Oh, don't tell me you was pastors.
I'm not that old. Neither is he. Neither was he. Oh, but he was sick. He needed me. So we went down to the park. In the morning, dead.
Oh, that is a shame.
Have a drink.
Oh, no thanks, love. I'll be getting on. I'd go round if I was you. Tell them what happened and watch them squirm. Good luck.
Oh,
Take your hands off me. I wouldn't spit on your charity now.
Well, are you drunk?
What if I am? It's keeping me warm, which is more than you did for my poor Polly.
But you wouldn't stay.
I know your lot. A life and death mean nothing to you. It's all rules and regulations, and we've got to be grateful. If the Lord Jesus was down here, he'd have a few things to say.
Oh, madam, you're being most unfair. Won't you come inside and have some soup?
With hymns for sweets? No, thank you.
Please, please let us help you.
Oh, leave me alone. I'll show you what you can do with your help.
Oh, dear.
Now you can smell the night air.
Oh. Well, go and have a drink with Peta. Do what you like.
I can't see the harm.
Don't you get enough of his smart theorizing at work?
I'm sorry, I found it rather interesting.
Oh, yes, you would. I mean, much more intellectual than what you get around here.
Oh, don't be silly, Meg.
Listen, all I know is that our friend Clements is up to something. He's got a smile like a shark and about the same interest in people.
Oh, that's rubbish. You've absolutely no right to say that. The man's an academic, Meg. They tend to sound like that. You can't... Have I said something amusing?
Anyone could string you along now, couldn't they?
Could they? I don't know.
He's on to us, you know.
Possibly. So what? You don't think he's shocked, do you? You should see the way they go on at universities, my God.
Yes, well, I wouldn't know about that, would I? I mean, I'm just a dumb screw.
Egg. Egg, stop it, please.
I'm sorry. Why don't you give us a kiss?
She sent the cops. Go away. There's been a mistake.
You're right. Now open this door.
Oh, my God. That's my husband.
You what?
Oh, you better let him in if he gets angry, you know.
He sounds bloody angry already.
So you're the little weasel, are you? You shameless bitch. How could you?
He seduced me. He offered me money.
Please, I didn't know. I'll make it up to you. She didn't say.
Make it up to me? For all the shame and the heartbreak?
Just leave me alone, eh? I'm terribly sorry this happened.
I think I'll have to teach you a serious lesson, my friend.
Here. Oh, wait. Wait. Look. Look, if I give you all this, we can forget it all happened, eh?
You're trying to buy me off?
Right, right. What do you say?
I'm not a man of violence by nature.
No, no, of course you're not.
All right, take your things and blow. While my good wife gets herself decent. And remember, I never forget a face, my friend.
I am, but so let's go out and eat. Now, Mr. Campbell and Mr. Hines are all very well.
No, I don't want to. I'm not in the mood. I don't want people staring at us and saying, look at that nice young man taking his mother out for a treat.
Oh, that's pathetic. I really do hope you enjoy yourself when you're gone like this.
I don't. I don't enjoy myself at all. Oh, I'm sick of being discreet when everyone knows anyway. I'm sick of wondering what the hell you see in me. I'm sick of worrying about someone younger and smarter coming along and... You're no use. You can't even tell me a few lies to cheer me up. I mean, you don't even want to think about it, do you?
Doesn't seem to be doing you much good.
Look... I was married to Bill for 17 years. I didn't run around having affairs. I mean, there were one or two blokes before I was married, but I've forgotten what it was like to just... Oh. I guess I'm not very cool. But my emotions just all get tangled up and, well, that's what I am anyway.
Meg, I'm very, very fond of you. I enjoy being with you.
But you're not making any promises.
How can I? And what would be the point?
None, I suppose. Well, I don't really want you to anyway.
What do you want?
I don't know.
Look, if you like, we can finish it right here. I can walk out. We can just be friends.
Oh, very funny.
Well?
No. No, don't do that.
You.
Oh, hello, Moni.
Right. Where have you been?
Over at Dorby's. Stayed the night.
That was only putting off the inevitable, Fred.
Oh, now look, Mon.
Because you know I'm going to bash you.
Well, what about a chance to explain, eh? I mean, be fair.
All right. Explain. Now, how about kicking off with $8,000?
You're not going to believe this, Mon.
Give it a whirl.
Well, it's all gone. I lost it all.
In one day?
Yeah, everything went wrong. You see, this jockey lied to me, and I went and put half the money on the horse's nose. A dead cert, he said. Rigged.
Yeah.
Well, I knew that you was going to be mad, so I went to this club to try and win it back, and, well, the table was rigged. And then these sailors come in. Oh, they were real big blokes, and...
You know, even if this were true, it wouldn't save your neck, Fred. $8,000 lovely dollars.
Last of the big-time spenders.
The last of the big-time losers, you little insect. And what about the $10,000 that you didn't owe the bookie?
Oh, that was for you.
That was mine already. You haven't had another woman while I've been inside, have you?
Oh, no, I swear. I swear to God in heaven, never.
Look, I'm going to kill her if I ever find her. You little runt that you are, you're mine. Get it!
Of course I am, Mon. True blue.
Yeah, well, this might help you.
No,
remember.
Monty, no.
I was going to take you on a holiday. Bali! America! Honolulu! Disneyland! Anywhere! You are grateful, little bugger!
Yeah, Grandma.
Grandma? If I wasn't so beholden to you, I'd spit in your eye.
I believe you would.
Listen, that money you lent me for the bail, I'll pay it back first thing.
I know. Now, listen, I'm being serious. Today's Thursday. Now you go and get your pension check and get yourself somewhere to live.
I'm not mad about sleeping out.
Some are, and there are laws about it.
I've never been in trouble with you boys in my life.
I know. Now, drink your tea and then you get along. You don't belong here.
Thank you, Sergeant.
Oh, Jack, I've got to go out, mate. Something's come up on that payroll snatch.
Oh, yeah?
Seems like the mugs are flashing it round again. I'll be over at the Bonanza Motel if you want me.
Yeah, fair enough. Been in the war, sport?
I'd like to lay a charge. Assault.
Come on. Some of us have got work to do, you know.
How much did you say?
25 a week, plus your power and gas.
I'm not quite sure. I think that...
Look, I've heard it all before, Mrs. You take it or leave it. Where are your things?
They're coming later.
You haven't got any pets, have you? No dirty little birds or anything?
No.
Anyway, by the look of you, I'm going to want a month in advance.
$100?
You itinerant, you'd ruin me if I let you. Now, your bathroom's down the end of the hall. There'll be no cooking with grease or fat in the rooms. There's a feed of an evening. $8 a week extra if you want to be in it.
Come on, come on, come on. Turn around.
Turn around. Hey, I can smell the drink on you.
Sorry.
There'll be none of that here.
Oh, with my record, what was the use? So I pleaded guilty and here I am again.
But if you told them what he did, I mean...
Very good, Lizzie. I reckon that alcohol finished you off forever.
Yeah, I reckon you must have walloped him properly this time.
Well, it's lucky I didn't kill him. I was ropeable.
What about the money?
Well, look, you got your key, didn't you? So stop worrying.
Yeah, but if your hubby's been running around flashing at places where he thinks people wouldn't know, I mean, how do you reckon they got hold of me?
Yeah, I didn't think about that.
What'd you do with the other 10 grand?
Got me own safety deposit box.
Oh, it's old home week. I knew we'd see you back here again, but you've surprised even me, Ferguson. Now I haven't heard the knock-off bell. Have you lot?
No, Miss Bennett.
Then get back to work.
Oh. They'll catch up with him for sure. You better make sure you've got a good story ready.
What are we going to do with all that money?
I'm going to put it in the fixed deposits.
Oh, can we have some fun for a change?
Good rate of interest will do me.
You are that boring, Bruce.
Look, I don't make judgments about your private life. That'll be breakfast.
Big deal.
Entrees. What's this?
Mr. and Mrs. Smith.
Listen, I think you blokes have got the wrong room.
Room 403, Mr. and Mrs. Smith.
Yeah, that's us. So what?
Have a look around, will you?
Now, just a minute.
We are the police, Mr. Smith. And we have reason to believe that you have certain money in your possession, which,
That money was a gift from a grateful man.
Yeah, must be $5,000-$6,000 here, Mrs. Smith. You the grateful man, Mr. Smith?
Yeah. I mean, no.
Never mind. You're in possession.
So what's all this about, anyway? What are we supposed to have done?
Hot money, Mrs. Smith. Hot money from a payroll job.
Look, a little rat named Ferguson gave me that money. And he never said anything about robberies and stuff.
You've been hanging around with criminals?
I'm afraid I'm going to have to ask you to accompany us to the station. Detective Parry will turn his back while you get changed.
Looks like it, Mr. Fletcher. Probably late this afternoon. Right. You got a bloke out at Wentworth now.
Yeah?
Makes a change.
I'm real sorry, Bruce.
I'm not speaking to you, Miss Crabtree.
Okay, darling, this bloke Ferguson, you know his address?
Carver Street, 22A.
Honour among thieves, eh, mate?
Oh, no risk. Hey, is that the same Ferguson was in here first thing? Little assault bloke?
Hang on. Carver Street, yeah.
The wife was arrested this morning.
Okay, you two. In there.
Hang on, love. What'd they give you?
Charity. Money from the poor box.
And bound you over to keep the peace, eh? Well, it's better than jail, love. Didn't you pick up your pension?
You ask my landlady that. She's the thief.
You mean she pinched it?
Oh, no. It's all very legal.
Well, Officer Clark will drive you home.
I'd rather walk, if you don't mind. My landlady might not approve.
Is it still raining outside? I'll tell you what. You take this. It'll keep you dry anyway.
Oh, no, I couldn't.
Come on, love is not charity. We got hundreds of them. People leave them here all the time. Go on, you take it.
Thank you, Sergeant.
Keep out of mischief, okay? Poor old biddy.
Yeah, a lot of it about though, mate.
Yeah.
Don't know why he wants to see you.
Why shouldn't he? I'm a criminal.
Doreen, come in. Peta? What do you want to see her for? Why not? Going by what you said last night, she's a classic loser.
Yeah, she's that all right. Still, you know what I think of her type.
You made that fairly clear last night.
Still, we could dig up better than that.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, no harm talking to her. Still, if you can come up with someone, I guess she wouldn't be the only one in here.
No, she's not the only one. How long do you need?
Oh, about an hour.
All right, go on.
Sit down, Doreen. Sit down. Cigarette? There's nothing to worry about, you know.
No, of course not. Don't think I'm going to say anything too interesting.
I'm sure you will. Someone with your experience.
I've been around.
Yes, you even escaped.
Yeah, but I gave myself up, bud.
Why?
Huh?
I said why.
Well, they would have caught me anyway. I'm not that smart.
Oh, who told you that?
Everybody tells me. All the time.
Did the screws tell you that?
Some of them. Suppose it's true, though, what they say about me. Dumb mole, no-hoper, useless.
Does Mr. Fletcher say these things?
Fletcher? I hate him. The way he looks at me. Like I'm a turd or something.
I'd like you to look at this and tell me what you think's happening. Take your time.
If Doreen gets cracking, she'll talk his ear off.
Yeah, she's a real little raver, our Doreen. She can whinge, all right, that's for sure.
There you go.
Settling in okay, Ferguson? Where's Anderson?
Gone to see the shrink.
Oh, I suppose you'll all be trotting along there soon. Anything to get out of a bit of work.
That's right, Vera.
You had a session, Smith?
Yes, as a matter of fact, I have.
What sort of things does he say to you?
What's it to you?
Oh, no, go on. I'm curious. What's he say?
Well, you know what they're like, Vera.
He shows you all these ink blots and asks you what you think. And some of them are real filthy. Wants to know when you learnt to use the dunny and do you wet your beak.
Yeah, but most of all, it's about
S-E-X. Are you getting enough? Do you miss it? Here, maybe it'd help you.
All right, that's enough.
Well, you did ask.
Hey, B, yeah? Did he ask you what you thought of the screws in here?
Yeah.
And I had to be honest.
Oh, I don't know why I bother with you lot.
Here, maybe you could ask him that too, Vera. Why do you? I don't see why it upsets you so much. It doesn't matter to me that you're a homosexual.
Why do you keep saying that?
You told me. You had a long-term female lover before you were arrested.
She was helping me when they took my kid away.
Did you find it unpleasant then, when she got into bed with you?
I was lonely. I'm sad.
Why didn't you find a man?
Because I'd had enough of them to last me, that's why.
They always turn out like your father, don't they?
Maybe.
What about Frankie Doyle?
She was my friend.
And now there's been Lynn Warner?
I didn't say nothing about...
Never mind that. Can you tell me now how you feel about this, this repeated pattern of loss?
What?
Well, you told me about your mother.
Yeah. She was good. A real lady.
Then why do you think she deserted you and your father?
Well, she must have had her reasons.
Can't have been too worried what happened to you.
Oh, look, please don't keep going on about me mum. It's not fair.
Well, the point is that ever since you have been forming these emotional attachments with women that always end in loss. Desertion, betrayal, even death.
Yeah, but it's not my fault. Are you saying it's my fault?
Okay, don't get hysterical. I am just suggesting that...
I don't want this! I don't want to talk to you anymore and you can't make me!
Oh, shit.
Colleen, what's the matter?
It's me. I'm the kiss of death. You asked that doctor bloke.
What's going on?
She's upset. Something Dr. Clements said to her, apparently.
Oh, you better get back to work. Go on, Anderson, back to the laundry.
She's upset.
What am I supposed to do? Wipe her nose?
Anderson's session's finished ahead of time, so could I please have Grafton, Wendy?
Mrs. Jackson will attend to that. I'm wanted in reception.
Ready for your next victim? What did you do to her?
I asked her a few questions and she attempted to answer them.
I knew you'd have this effect on the women.
Did you? How splendidly intuitive of you. Now, could I please have Grafton?
So, they let you out, eh?
I beg your pardon?
You pulled the little old lady on them, did you? Bloody cops. Soft in the head, the lot of them. No wonder we got so many crims running loose.
I don't know what you're talking about.
I'm talking about you, and you know it. Mrs. Barlow down the hall saw you. Don't you try and con me. I'm not having any thieves in my house. This is a respectable place.
But
nothing. If you're not out of here in 5 minutes, I'll have you thrown out.
But you can't do that. I paid you a month in advance.
So, sue me. Right! That does it!
Don't you come near me! Stay away! Stay away! I'm warning you!
Oh, don't you! Hey! You old bitch! Now get out! Help! Murder! I'll get you! Get out!
Possession of stolen money. Well, you'd meet all sorts in your line of work.
I'm on remand, miss.
All right, stand up straight.
Hey, you let me do that, all right?
Thank you, sir.
Ah, yes, let me guess what you're in here for. How much do you charge?
More than you could pay.
Shut up. Crabtree's with us on remand. The old one got 7 days. She'll need a thorough scrub-up. She stinks.
All right.
Damage to private property. Assault and battery. Well, you wouldn't think it to look at her, would you?
I said all right, Miss Bennett. Look, just lay off. What are you trying to prove?
I'm just saying why she...
I heard you. Now, leave her alone. Now, come on, love. You just stand over there with your toes on that white line there. That's the way. Good girl. You'll be all right.
Rotten bitch! Where'd she put it?
Police, Mr. Ferguson. We met earlier today, remember?
Yeah.
Have you lost something?
No, it's always like this.
Mr. Ferguson, we have information that yesterday you visited the following premises. The Ritz Fur Salon, Deuce and More Nightwear, Hot Stuff Fashions, Mitzi's Perfumery and the Overture Bar and Grill. And we have witnesses.
Yeah, I was there. So what?
And Mr. Ferguson, at each of those places, you paid cash with money that was taken in a payroll job.
You're joking. But I borrowed that money from Monica, my wife. She sold the shop. Well, that's where the money come from, wasn't it?
Well, we'll ask her about that, won't we? I mean, after all, we know where she is. In the meantime, if you'd...
Yeah, I know.
What money?
Well, your husband's been spending it, a lot of it.
Has he now? Well, I wish I'd seen some of it. On another woman, I suppose.
That's correct.
Yeah, well, that's why I thumped him, see?
And he claims the money was yours. And he also mentioned the sale of the shop. But we checked that. It hasn't gone through, has it?
No. So where would he get a lot of money?
Well, supposing you tell us, eh?
Okay, I'll have a go at it. I mean, this is obviously funny money, otherwise you blokes wouldn't care, right? Well, I reckon Fred's got his hands on something, but don't ask me how. And he's been dumb enough to spread it around. He gets done, so he's trying to pin it on me out of spite. I mean, it's not enough that he puts a charge of assault on his own wife.
You know a Joyce Martin?
Sure, she's in here. Close mouth type. Why?
Well, we'll leave it at that for the time being, eh?
Okay.
Oh, there you are. Where you been? Hey, Doreen.
Go away.
What you doing?
Thinking.
Oh, come on. Someone been getting at you. That old Fletcher.
Mostly that Clements bloke.
Yeah?
He said I was home. Sexual. A lesbian.
Well, love, you don't want to
do. Oh, and Lizzie, he said there's no hope for me.
Oh,
everyone leaves me because I'm no good for anything.
Come on, come on. You'll be all right. You've just been through a bad time, that's all. You've got friends. Of course you have.
Who?
You got me. You got your old Lizzie.
And then, now get this, he says, how splendidly intuitive of you, the smug supercilious. I could have slapped his face.
Yes, so you said.
Oh, am I boring you?
No.
Well, what do you think?
I think you may be jumping to conclusions. Doreen is an immature, inadequate girl. We all know that. What do you have to understand?
Why do I have to understand? Why can't I just be right?
I'm not saying you're not right.
Why can't you agree with me just for once?
I thought we were talking about something. I mean, discussing rationally whether or not... But I don't know what we are talking about.
The man is a callous bastard.
All right. He lacks the concern or whatever it is you think he should have. However...
Now, don't you use that patient, sarcastic tone with me. I know all I am is splendidly intuitive, but I am not going to be patronized twice in the one day.
Why are we going on and on about this? I don't give a stuff about this. The man makes you feel small, that's your problem. My God, it's so boring.
Oh, yes. Shut up, Megan. Let's go to bed, huh?
I'll see you tomorrow, I expect. Good night, Megan.
It's really shaking me, Bea. I feel all churned up inside.
Now, come on, were you really that surprised?
I suppose I always thought, but really knowing.
Oh, yeah, I know.
Oh, did you find her?
Yeah, in the cell. She was a bit upset, so I tucked her in.
Well, what's up?
Well, the shrink's been telling her a few home truths.
It's about time somebody did.
There's that new bird who was it too.
Oh, yeah, on remand.
She looks like a pro.
Could be.
Hi. Like your dress.
Oh, thanks.
What are they trying to pin on you then?
Oh, it's all stupid. They reckon I was in possession of stolen money from some payroll. Don't know nothing about it.
Well, how'd they catch up with you then?
Oh, it's this little runty bloke. He wouldn't look twice at him, only he had $8,000. Didn't say anything about it being hot, though. I was helping him spend it, all in good faith.